Welcome student to the next topic, that is aseptic area and microbial control. As we in microbiology are working on microorganism, so both the aspect, that is growth of a microorganism for some experimental purposes or for understanding their life cycle, similar way the death or the killing of a microorganism, so that we can get a microbial free products or the microbiological controlled product. So in this lecture we are basically going to discuss on how we are going to control the microorganism, as well as if we want to work out with the product, how we are going to consider the aseptic area. Now if we talk about the content of this lecture, so first we'll introduce ourselves to the aseptic techniques, then we'll be moving to the designing of a aseptic area, that means how to develop the aseptic area, what is the layout of aseptic area, sort of things. Then we'll be going through the equipment, that is laminar airflow. After that we'll find out the different sources of contamination, specifically in aseptic area, and how we can prevent them, that is the method of prevention. Next part we'll look out with some specification of a clean area or the classification of clean area, and finally we'll discuss some of the aspects, that is environmental cleanliness and disposable of a microbial waste. So moving to the first part, that is introduction to aseptic technique. Now what are aseptic technique? So we know that is we are basically working on some of the products, some of the dosage form, which we say that is it should be free from microorganism, or there are number of microorganisms, whatever it is present in that product, that should be limited. Not only microorganism, but also we can say the particles. So whenever we want to carry out aseptic technique, what we know, what we want, that is a physical area, an area where we can actually perform aseptic techniques in a proper manner. So this is something like, it is also called as a clean area, which is designed for controlling microbial contamination. So what we say, that is controlling microbial contamination. So even if there is some sort of microorganism or particles are there, we can control them so that our product, whatever the product we are forming, that should be free from or controlled microbial number. So what is the significance or important of a aseptic area? Why do we need to develop the aseptic area, or what is the significance of it? Now when we say about sterile product, we know it should be free from microorganism, that means it should not even contain a single cell of microorganism. Likewise, there are certain products are there whereby we are allowing the specific amount of bacteria or the specific number of bacteria, but that is again a very low number of bacteria. So if we carry out this process in a normal environmental condition, as we know, that is the normal environmental condition in air, okay, or on the surfaces of a floor, okay, there are number of microorganisms are there, so they can interfere with our process. So to deal with that, what we can do, that is we can work out for dealing with a clean area which is designed for this controlling microbial contamination, or it is also called as a aseptic area. So that is the importance of a aseptic area. If we talk about product which are prepared in aseptic area, so just now we said that is sterile product, the product which does not contain a single cell of microorganism, or it is free from microorganism, that is one category which we are preparing in the aseptic area. While along with that, we had again said that is there are few other products whereby the microbial contamination or the number of microorganism is very low. So again, such type of product we can easily formulate into the aseptic area. Now you may say, that is why don't we go for all the products in the aseptic area? If it is a clean area, if it is a microorganism free area, so we can prepare almost all product in this particular area. So why don't we go for this sort of condition? So if we talk about the other products which are not a sterile product, what we say, that is we are preparing it in a hygienic area. Now when we say about hygienic area, again we say that is it is with a controlled atmosphere. Again, it is having a reduced microorganism as compared to the normal environmental condition, and that is what we are observing it in a pharmaceutical industry, pharmaceutical or a manufacturing industry. So in pharmaceutical manufacturing or in production, we are again taking care of, that is to minimize the contamination. So this area, what we can say, it is a hygienic area where the number of microorganism may be more if we compare with the aseptic area, but yes, those many number of microorganisms are permitted as per the standard books in those particular products. So that is why they are called as a hygienic area. If we compare with aseptic area, that is hygienic area and aseptic area, hygienic area may contain few microorganism, or the number may be little bit high if we compare with the aseptic area. Maintenance of hygienic area, that is easy if we compare with aseptic area. Then the guidelines or the protocols followed in the hygienic area are different from the aseptic area. So these are some of the differences what you can find out into the hygienic area and aseptic area. Now moving to the designing of a aseptic area. So if we talk about aseptic area, it is a specially designed area. Okay, so that is what we say, clean rooms, they are the specially designed area for controlling the microorganism. Now what are the things we have to control through this part? The first one, that is floors, walls and ceilings, doors, windows, services like gas, vacuum, personal protective clothing and cleaning and disinfection. So these are some of the aspects that we have to take care when actually we are designing the aseptic area. So here you can look out in this diagram, you can look out the layout for the aseptic area, in which if we start from the office, you can find out that is for there is only one directional movement that you can find out in this area, that is the one who is entering in the office from a airlock door will only go toward the compounding area or in the stockroom. So again, from the stockroom he'll move to the cleanup area, sterilization, packaging, okay, or if it goes to the compounding area, from office to a compounding area, then to the aseptic filling, quarantine. So likewise, you won't find that is the person can come backside, that means from the sterilization to the cleanup area or from packaging finishing to the sterilization area. So that is not allowed in the aseptic area. If we talk about the floors, walls or the ceiling, then these are again the specially designed one. So here if we talk about the floors, walls and the ceiling, they are coated with the antimicrobial paint. So whatever normal floors and walls or ceilings are there, so the similar way they are prepared, but the special coating of an antimicrobial is provided on those particular surfaces to ensure there is no microbial contamination can occur. If we talk about doors and windows, so again the doors you can see that is they are with the airlock system. So always the positive pressure is maintained inside the room so that the air can go outside from that particular room but cannot enter inside that particular room. Again all the doors should be with a proper airlocking system. Windows, if required, there are some windows you can find to this particular area, but they are the locked windows. That means you cannot open those particular windows. It can be just for the observation, that is what is going on in that particular area. If we talk about the services like gas and vacuum, again the special care we have to take care, we have to take care about these particular services, like whatever the gas pipes or the vacuum pipes we are installing in this particular area should be again the mostly in the underground, or if it is even touching to the wall, so that should be fitted properly so that there should not be any sort of contamination which is coming from this particular services. If we talk about personal protective clothing, again the clothings are stored inside this area only. That means whenever the person is going to enter into the aseptic area, he is going to change his clothing which is present inside that aseptic area itself. So that is where what we can say, either in the office or there is a separate room is also available in some layout for this particular changing of a cloth. Again, whenever you are going out, you have to just remove those particular clothes inside that aseptic area only. Cleaning and disinfection. So again, here there are the different cleaning agents or disinfectants are used in this particular area, and it is a daily, on a daily basis or on a regular basis. So regularly, or even after a particular hours, or even after a particular batch, if the batch is a short batch, so after each batch or after each regular time interval, okay, we have to clean or we have to disinfect those particular area. So one of the process which is used once a week or once a month or once a 15 days, that is depending upon the conditions, and we can use something like the fumigation method or any other suitable method for the same. In next lecture, we'll go through the laminar airflow equipment, then the sources of contamination and method of prevention, then the clean area classification, and finally the environmental cleanliness and disposable of a microbial waste. Thank you.